Since the moment the main battle tank first rolled onto the battlefield, nothing has ever been the same. These armored behemoths redefined the nature of ground combat, shifting the balance of power in ways that changed warfare forever. Among the most iconic of these modern giants are the British Challenger 2 and the American M1 Abrams, two tanks that embody the pinnacle of Western military might. Their presence on the battlefield is more than just a show of force. They are symbols of technological mastery, strategic superiority, and unyielding dominance. The Challenger 2, with its legendary toughness and proven combat record, has become a symbol of resilience, while the Abrams, renowned for its speed and adaptability, represents the cutting edge of battlefield innovation. Both tanks have earned a near-mythical status in military circles, not just because of their raw power, but due to their ability to dominate in diverse combat environments. Together, these tanks define the Western approach to armored warfare, where firepower, protection, and mobility converge to create a near unbeatable force that has kept them at the forefront of global military strategy for decades. Challenger 2 is a main battle tank designed and manufactured by BAE Systems Land and Armaments, originally by Vickers Defense Systems. From a technological standpoint, the Challenger 2 is robust and formidable. The tank's body is about 27 feet 6 inches long, excluding the gun. But when the gun is included, its length extends to 37 feet 9 inches. The Challenger 2 is a width of 11 feet 8 inches and stands about 8 feet 2 inches tall. It is a heavy-duty machine with a combat-ready weight of approximately 82.7 short tons with add-on armor modules. Under the hood, the Challenger 2 is equipped with a Perkins CV-12 6A V12 diesel engine that outputs an impressive 1,200 horsepower. This high horsepower gives the tank significant speed capabilities. On roadways, the Challenger 2 can reach speeds of 37 miles per hour, while off-road terrains will slow it down slightly to 25 miles per hour. One of the key aspects of the Challenger 2 is its long operational range. It can traverse up to 342 miles on road surfaces and approximately 156 miles off-road. The operational crew of the Challenger 2 includes four members: a commander, gunner, loader, and driver. The driver is situated at the front hull of the tank, while the other crew members occupy the turret. The Challenger 2's battlefield efficiency is significantly bolstered by its suite of combat awareness features. It comes fitted with Thales Optronics Battlegroup thermal imaging sights for both the gunner and the commander. This ensures operational readiness in all weather conditions and around the clock. The tank's digital battlefield management system further amplifies the crew's situational awareness by delivering real-time data and information, enhancing their decision-making ability in dynamic combat scenarios. Additionally, the commander is equipped with a panoramic SAGEM VS580-10 gyro-stabilized sight integrated with a laser rangefinder, offering a comprehensive visual command of the battlefield. The protective armor on the Challenger 2 is exceptional and noteworthy. The tank utilizes second-generation Chobham armor known as Dorchester, which offers substantial protection against different forms of threats. While the exact composition of the armor remains classified, it's understood that it includes ceramics and composite materials. As additional layers of defense, the Challenger 2 can be outfitted with explosive reactive armor and has a soft kill system, the Thales Air Defense Alerting Device. This device provides early warning of incoming missile threats. In the event of a nuclear, biological, or chemical attack, the tank offers NBC protection, ensuring the crew's safety. The Challenger 2's armament is as impressive as its protective features. Its L30A1 gun, unique among NATO main battle tank weapons, is rifled. Together with its predecessor, the Royal Ordnance L11A5, these are the only third-generation main battle tank guns to employ a rifled barrel. The British Army's continued preference for high-explosive squashhead or HESH rounds, in addition to armor-piercing, fin-stabilized, discarding sabot rounds, explains this choice. HESH rounds provide a range advantage, reaching up to 5 miles further than APFSDS rounds, and offer superior effectiveness against buildings and thin-skinned vehicles. Much of the operational prowess of the Challenger 2 stems from its sophisticated digital integrated control system, a cutting-edge fire control system. This system facilitates dynamic combat engagements, allowing the tank crew to successfully target and attack moving adversaries even while the tank itself is on the move. Moreover, the fire control system is engineered to function in a hunter-killer mode. This mode provides the flexibility for the commander and gunner to independently scan for and engage targets, thereby amplifying the tank's combat potential. While the Challenger 2 stands as a fortress on tracks, with its legendary resilience and ability to withstand punishing hits, the M1 Abrams complements this might by embodying speed and adaptability, showcasing a different but equally formidable approach to modern armored warfare. The M1A2 main battle tank has a commanding appearance on the battlefield. It's about 32 feet long when the gun is pointed forward, which is roughly as long as 3 average cars lined up end to end. Its width is around 12 feet, almost like placing 2 SUVs next to each other. The tank stands at a height of 8 feet. The M1A2 Abrams tank is really heavy, weighing about 137,000 pounds, or 62 metric tons. In other words, it's almost as heavy as 20 SUVs put together. Needless to say, only an engine of a very high grade can give such a vehicle the speed and agility required to do its job. When you first hear the engine of an M1 start, you immediately realize that this isn't just any main battle tank. Instead of the typical diesel engine roar, what you hear resembles the sound of a jet aircraft gearing up for takeoff. That's because the Honeywell Automotive Gas Turbine AGT-1500 draws inspiration from aircraft and automotive technologies. Weighing approximately 2,500 pounds and occupying a volume of 40 cubic feet, the AGT-1500 is relatively compact for its power output. It is known for its high power output, peaking at 1,500 horsepower. Even at lower RPMs, It can provide significant torque. It gives the M1 Abrams tank a top speed of around 45 miles per hour on a paved surface and 30 miles per hour cross-country. This tank can go from rest to 20 miles per hour in 6 seconds. Diesel fuel is used most of the time, since it is more resilient to fire than other fuel types, and believe it or not, the density of this liquid provides an extra layer of protection in the tank. However, M1's engine can operate on any grade of diesel fuel, any grade of jet fuel, any grade of kerosene, and even any grade of gasoline. One of the unique features of the AGT-1500 is its composition of 5 submodules, including a rotating gas producer, an accessory gearbox, power turbines, a reduction gearbox, and a recuperator. The recuperator is a particularly innovative feature that enhances the engine's efficiency. It is a regenerative heat exchanger that uses waste heat from exhaust gases to preheat compressed air. This submodule also reduces the thermal signature of the tank to protect it against heat-seeking anti-tank missiles and makes it less visible on the enemy's thermal vision equipment. You know how average tank engines make a lot of noise? Well, this one doesn't. The M1 Abrams tank distinguishes itself by being remarkably quiet, approaching enemy positions undetected. This stealthy feature led to its nickname, Whispering Death. Even though M1 Abrams got slower with every version, its armor became a legend on its own. The formidable reputation of the M1 Abrams tank is not solely attributed to its advanced armor or its cutting-edge engine. The essence of this metal warrior lies in its singular purpose, the decisive defeat of enemy forces. The M1 Abrams has a distinguished track record of achieving this objective. Central to this success is the power and precision of its main weapon. The M1A2 Abrams main battle tank has a formidable main gun, the M256 120mm smoothbore cannon. This highly effective weapon is a derivative of the Rheinmetall 120mm gun used by the German Leopard 2 tank. The M256 gun has been adapted for the Abrams tank to provide high accuracy and lethality. It is capable of firing a variety of ammunition types, including armor-piercing, fin-stabilized, discarding sabot or APFSDS rounds, with depleted uranium, high-explosive anti-tank, heat rounds, and canister rounds for use against personnel and light material targets. The M1A2 Abrams tank is operated by a crew of 4, each with a specialized role crucial for the tank's operations. The commander, gunner, and loader are located in the turret. When the turret rotates, these crew members rotate with it. The commander oversees the entire tank's operations, making strategic decisions, managing communications, and scanning for threats or targets using advanced systems like the commander's independent thermal viewer, or CITV. The gunner, seated next to the commander, is responsible for operating the tank's main gun and secondary armaments. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the mighty Challenger 2 and the fearsome M1 Abrams main battle tanks. So, what do you think about these fascinating armored giants? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to see these vehicles up close, or better yet, operated one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.